I think we're ready to go. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's head into Clubhouse. We're going to verify our bands and make sure all is good. And after that, we'll just head into the game. Because
fingers crossed. Don't rehost for the rehosts, and we're good. So.
And they are correct.
Cool.
Let's go.
All right. Well, let's see some fighting here. Let's see what we got.
Glaz. Yep. Necrox playing Glaz.
He's probably going to sixth pick into it then.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Huh, here's the thing. If they're expecting cash, it makes a lot of sense to play the Monty, actually. We've seen Monty takes in Garage. You talked about this before.
I've also seen a lot of them fail early on. Yes. I feel like some of them have gotten a little bit better, but they just, I don't know. Glaz takes as well have been a bit of a mixed success.
I actually prefer the Monty just because it allows you to go through a garage and clear players out in that position.
It depends on who's playing it. Some people are a little sloppier in terms of Glaz counterplay, and Glaz will get away with a lot in terms of his ability to see that little yellow sliver. But yeah, it absolutely does matter.
Necrox definitely has a lot of history playing the Operator, especially on Clubhouse. We'll see maybe later if we head down to Church, if he's just going to be moving through oil pit into blue, which is something he does quite a bit. But reinforcements up on the patio, nothing surprising. It's always interesting to see how Echoes sometimes set up their drones. So Vandal might have a couple positions for the Yokais. We've seen Papa Brian actually using one here on the staircase leading up. As
10 seconds remaining.
There's a... I don't know if we could actually show it. Marcio,
camera feed
could I ask you to head up to the stairs? Yeah, upstairs. One more? Yes. So you see in the side stairs there where Vandal is, there's a light on the side. There's a light fixture there. So what you can do by that light fixture is actually hover your Yokai drone into it and actually has no disruption on the lighting, which means it's practically invisible. And you can learn that yourself. Try it yourself. It's a very strong position for a Yokai.
Reminds me of a lot of camera positions for Black Eyes as well, where a lot of them will take advantage of lighting or other positions where just because of the way things are lit, you can't tell they're there. Well, Geo, though, playing very aggressive in terms of trying to take blue.
Yeah, he's just on in first. We've seen that huge resurgence in Capitao. I believe he's number 6 most big operator on the attacking side. He basically just whiffs away. The shots that are just passing through from Garage. You have to be really careful here. Of course, remind you, there's only one Heartbreacher available. So any work done to Young is really going to cost you and hamper you if you're EG.
Yeah, now I gotta imagine Young being a very, very long-term player here. Should be fine on that. He's already opening up the garage side in terms of the garage doors. That was a little bit dangerous. We see a lot of Thermite players running way too close to that door when you could definitely run a bit further away. So it seems a bit risky to me to be playing like that. We've seen a lot of Thermites die that way. But hey, he lived through it, so.
It is deceiving, actually, the angle. If you're on the attack and you don't really play on the rafters, if you play defense on the attack.
Yeah, you can't tell how easy it is for them to see you.
Exactly, and it's a pretty big angle that
you're... That's the thing you always have to think about, is your camera's all around your head.
Oh, so. Frag grenades are in the hands of Canadian here, so he's going to try to go for a bit of a quick peek here. And no, the ADS is right above. The Ash will come in and flash, or the flashbangs will come in from the side. I believe that's Young. Grenade will hit, but do no damage, basically, to Ghost, who's still up and ready. Necrox, though, will find the kill on Hyper. They're trying to get the second, and Geo, the one to finish off Ghost. A great start here for EG as they force Ryze into fighting them. And in that situation, overwhelming firepower from EG, especially Necrox just holding the angles, will be more than enough. Canadian running away. His Beastly will spot him, but can't really react to his opponent. Still in construction. At least he knows he'll be safe in this position.
That was a very aggressive but very clean take of Garage. It definitely, they didn't take any damage in the process outside of Necrox taking a bit, but he's going to be, I imagine, playing in smoke when he can and hopefully not taking too much more damage. And they're meantime able to open up some more angles in, just putting a ton of pressure on. But 30 seconds left, though, they have to make a move, and this is where Capitao comes into play. Unfortunately, but Necrox peed away the wrong
way. Oh, he finds it! Vandal! Going down to Necrox, but where are the two last players? They're so far away. MVK will get one, and Necrox the second, and that's all that they needed. A Valkyrie trying to haunt EG's dreams, but here they're just all set in the cemetery. At this point, the C4 could not be thrown up at the end by Ryze, and just seemingly unresponsive. EG just barely take any damage in that skirmish, and got a pretty easy round here. This prompts Ryze Nation to go down to Church and Arsenal, which makes a lot of sense. Mute's going to be a hyper-important operator for this one, but the hatches, those are going to be complicated for EG to deal with because, again, only Thermite's up.
Yeah, you don't have the ability to electrify those just yet. Coming second half, in theory. We haven't firmly established whether or not those will be in the second half of the season yet, but I imagine they will be. So it's some six picks coming out there as well. Obviously, the Blitz not coming out, but trying to keep people on their toes. In this case, the Glass will be coming out yet again. And if, I mean, you pretty much got to expect that the Thermite's coming out. They could make things a bit more of a wild card by having someone else in place and then six picking over to the Thermite if they don't have anyone else they want to six pick to. Just so you don't know which operator is going to get replaced because you know the Thermite's coming. It's a little bit of mind games you could play in theory. But yeah, that was definitely not the level of take they were expecting in terms of Garage. And I like to see that efficiency. I only hope they can be as efficient on the attack here in terms of clearing the entire upper half, right? Making sure they have control again of blue quickly, then taking control of the upper floors. Because pretty much if you cut off blue and then take control of the upper floors, you're pretty much only going to have to fight someone in cash at the very least. They are setting up for the impact trick as well. Ghost's going to be playing for that, which is no surprise. I mean, it seems like there was kind of a period where it seemed to kind of die off a little bit, but it's definitely come back and forth because of the importance of hatches now, and because there's usually a limited amount of hard breachers because there's at least one band most of the time on Clubhouse.
In this case, it's even worse, and EG might have to go for a dirt tunnel push.
Yeah, they're definitely going to have to choose wisely. At least the Glaz is somewhat useful for a dirt tunnel push, but looks like he's going to be used to help clear things out first.
You can definitely use the Glaz to come in from blue and just try to pinch out your opponents. In this case, you still need to take control of the blue stairs. You need to push usually the Jaeger that's playing in that position just because there's some ADSs to help him out so it doesn't get instantly flashed or grenaded in the back behind that generator. So Canadian just droning in, realizing, you know, the setup that's happening, which is basically very standard. There's a couple Mew Jammers. You would expect it when the bandit is banned. And Capitao in the meantime here, Mr. Geo, is coming around from the side. This makes a lot of sense. He's looking to support his teammate in this.
No, I like this because he can get past ADSs to really pressure Jaeger there.
Exactly. And, you know, this is the question as well if you're on the attack here. It's like, okay, well, we want to push Armory. We'll have to destroy the kitchen hatch and also destroy the wall leading into construction.
Yeah.
It's either that or, well, we're just going to go for a church take, which means our setup is going to be completely different. And in this case, I believe they're just going to go for a standard play on church. You already see the flashbangs being thrown into burn out any ADSs. The AMPs will take down two Mew Jammers, which leaves Vandal with one that's going to put it down. Now, I'm not sure if he still has any utility. In the meantime, though, Young will be able to open up the left-hand side wall. C4 will not connect, but it does destroy
the
second charge. This is huge here.
Yeah, they're definitely going to have to attack this in a different way. It's going to come down to gunfights. That wall also reinforced. They cannot play that way. Moto, and as well as the pinch here from Canadian and possibly Geo from the side, is going to make a big difference in whether or not this works or not. Because, well, then they can attack Church at least from that side. But Young now really having to rethink things.
And this is the problem now. If you're on the attack, you just don't know how you'll be able to function with only one hard breacher. There's not a lot of flexibility with it. And now they're trying, EG here, trying to use as little utility as possible for the Glaz to be able to operate as close as possible to the church. Necrox will move on closer, but he's being damaged by the smoke. He's still alive inside of it as he's just going to go in and take down England. That's one cleanup, but Vandal is still around. That's the diffuser now on the floor, right up in the open. Canadian will challenge the Legion as Ghost will take a ton of damage, but it's not enough. The diffuser's already been set, so it's now up to Rise Nation to push up towards it and clear it all up. And you see the players moving in. They're trying to shut down Young on this rotation. Playing the Jaeger will make it through an NVK in the perfect spot. Watching, you can try to long arm it here, and he will spot the side of the SMG, but they're all going to watch it. The Mute is right behind as well. Beastly's just going to stick this one in Canadian. No!
They just NVK! Not do that.
Unfortunate.
They were absolutely expecting the arm or something to be sticking out to give some kind of indication, but nope, he's got a nice short gun for that, thankfully. Had it been an operator with a longer gun, maybe it would have actually poked out a little bit.
He spotted it, actually.
Oh, looks like we might be having issues with Geo's internet, and we might have to bring good old Gotcha in after all.
Oh, man.
Well, at least we were able to pick up one round with Geo first, but it's possible that round might have been partially a struggle because of Geo's internet connections, hard to say. But either way, I doubt anything going to change in terms of you know, who that round goes to. But Rise Nation, that C4 to stop the Thermite, absolutely critical to winning that. But to be fair, they did still get the plant down just not with the level of control they could have gotten with that wall open.
And you know what that breaks? That breaks the mindset of, oh, well, if you want to deny a thermite there, then you have to leave the sidewall in the hallway soft. No, you don't.
Yeah.
You saw it.
I expect to see more repeats of that if you think you can get away with it. Because we usually see C4s focused on trying to deny anyone at the bottom of stairs coming in through the doorway. Just not a lot of people trying to do it for the thermite charge. And if people run away, well, they're running away rather than shooting your C4 out of the air anyway. So either people are going to, you know, switch to like Buck Skeleton King to try and get it out of the air or something along that lines, or hoping they can shoot it, or just dealing with it. Because the thing is, you can't cook a C4 the way you can a grenade. So
because you need to call it.
Yeah. So it is a case where you can't do anything about the delay. You can change the arc slightly. But if that does become a more common thing, we might see some counters to it. So I wouldn't expect that to like completely change church, but it certainly changes some thinking about what you do in a situation where you only have thermite and what your backup plan is.
Yeah, and in this case, the contingency plan for EG was like, okay, let's just go and plant. And you saw NVK there at the top watching the hatch, saw the front side of the barrel of the UMP. It's a shorter SMG, so it's not as easy to spot, but he did spot it, but he wasn't sure if they're going to stick it or not. And I'm not sure if there was any drones or anything. It definitely seemed like there wasn't.
No, they probably had to use a lot just to try and help them get in because of being denied the wall. So.
And that was very problematic in that position. There were three players alive still on the attack, three on the defense. All the defense just piled up, tried to block as many bullets as possible. If the attackers were to dive down and try to save the day, unfortunately, they didn't even get the chance.
Yeah, it's unfortunate that Necrox did not see the second player stand up kind of behind the player he was killing. And had he been able to do so, he might have been able to catch them both.
I think the mute was... I'm not sure if it was playing by the other side,
but it looked like he kind of... And it was hard to tell because the yellow overlay.
Yeah, I thought when he flicked around to the second side, I think he saw him behind the bomb. Like the actual bomb.
Might have moved at that point.
Yeah. So
either way,
he got the kill and then moved away.
Yeah.
And yeah. Unfortunately, in that position, you were low on health and everything. The fact that he still got the smoke, anyways, was.
I'm surprised he was able to live through the toxic gas as well, but it's just probably enough.
A spectator thing as well.
Yeah. There are sometimes things where you can't exactly tell where the gas is from the spectator. Something that we've noticed recently. It might be not communicating to the audience completely where the smoke actually is. But in this case, it did seem like it did a fair amount of damage to him. So,
it's possible that there's some desyncs between spectator and what's going on in the game itself. That's completely fine. But it seems like the problems on Geo's side are a bit too difficult. So we will get Gotcha in to sub. As again, if you guys didn't know, if you have a coach on the team registered for the squad, and you need a replacement, a substitute for a game, your coach is the first one that's actually in there.
And that's going to be very common because very few teams actually have subs on the bench because it's just there's a lot of problems with having
subs. Keep a player like
that
on the side.
It's expensive. It's demotivating to a lot of players. So they don't get the same level of practice most of the time. So it is very difficult. It is something that you would love to have, but there are a lot of issues with trying to maintain a sub.
And the current ecosystem is not.
Yeah.
Not really that important.
And a coach is most often still going to be participating in everything that the team is doing to an extent, depending on what kind of coach they are and how hands-on they are. So more often than not, if they are also a former player, like Gotcha, he can step in, knows all the strats, knows how to even, like, if he had to temporarily IGL, could do that in the sense that he knows, in a sense, what everyone should be doing on the plays. I mean, but in this case, I believe Troy's pretty consistently filling that in still. So.
Yep. Well, Gotcha is in, and of course he's the coach. From what I'm told, at least what we had an interview with Gotcha a couple weeks ago, or I want to say a couple weeks
ago. It's blowing together.
It's super years.
You have to say play days at this point.
Yeah, a couple. I think it was like on the first play day when we were on 2019.
Yeah.
And he's like, you know, we kind of had the mix. We still have Canadian mostly doing it, but I'm there. I'm filling information. And as you mentioned, Gotcha definitely has experience. He's played in Challenger League. He's been coaching the squad for a few months now. And he's proven himself on multiple occasions. So Gotcha's a pretty okay player.
Yeah, I definitely think he's a decent fill-in. I mean, I imagine they would want to play with their main players most of the time. It's never an ideal situation, but that flexibility is definitely key to EG being able to stay in this. But it's 1-1. So this could go either way. However, this already is almost the maximum points that have been allotted to Rise Nation on this map so far.
Yeah.
In the past.
If I'm not mistaken, having that one rehost to get a player in. I think that EG don't have any possible rehosts after this. So
that's a tough spot to be in.
Back in the day, it was much, much bigger. But yeah, I'd like to correct myself. Before, I think it was Latin America Play Day with FaZe and Liquid, they were allowed 3 rehosts just because these are like natural incidents where it's a storm and you can't really control that, obviously. Whereas in this case, you have a substitute and everything. Realistically, the rules are just you get 1 rehost. Now, in this case, EG are going to change up the way they're attacking. You saw the first time they went for mostly glass solo. This time, they're also bringing Young on the Monty, which symbolizes...
Yeah, got you to the Thermite then.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. You know, Young was playing that operator.
He was the OG shield. This map especially, on the Recruit Shield Dirt Tunnel, was
oh
like...
Oh my god.
That was a thing.
Even back,
sure.
Even back on Hereford base.
Yeah.
Oh, year 1, season 1 and... Season 1 or 2?
He's the OG shield player. Even when it came down to Blackbeard or anyone else, if there was a shield... Young was the guy to play it, and he still is the go-to guy for that.
Recruit Shield was actually a thing in Pro League.
Yeah, for those of you who don't know, he used to be a little bit faster and then brought good extra utility.
Yeah.
He was a force to be reckoned with.
Very true. No longer the case, I think, fortunately.
Yeah, it is for the best. It was definitely something that was a little bit of a destabilizing force, but either way, Young will still find a shield to play on. He could go with Blitz as well, but he wants to go with one that he can focus more on supporting his teammates rather than going for pressure or frags. He will be able to do also, of course, some initial droning, and then he's also bringing some extra smokes to help out Necrox, so getting some good double duty out of that as well. He is often very useful for helping smoke for the actual plant, whereas Glez might use 1 or 2 of his smokes earlier to help with some of the support plays to get players killed out of important areas. They're going for a little bit of a different take this time, Castle being in the mix as well. It's going to change things up. And we did see these breaches being brought previously by NBK, and they are coming in very useful. I mentioned earlier Sophia bringing them as well for similar reasons, to be able to take care of Castle barricades that are safer. Now that, of course, doors you don't see them on as much because your feet are exposed, but in this case, they had already cleared it first, so was safe to go ahead and blow that up. And they will get some okay map control. They did clear the lounge there with that drone, and then Canadian taking down the Jaeger, the body falling right onto him, so he could, you know, pull the spine out like a trophy.
Attackers have located a bomb.
They are going to have Young, though, already taking over the garage and getting some good early control. Not as swift as last time, but they are still establishing that, and losing Hype early, who is pretty much the top frag on the team and definitely one of their strongest players, is going to be a huge detriment and possibly lead to them losing this once again, as this garage take has done exactly what it needed to do and Gotcha going to do his thing.
And this is the thing. Bringing the Monty allows you to be, oddly enough, it's going to seem very odd that I'm using the word, but very flexible in how you're going to attack. It allows you to take control of the outside, but also to move in and block any fire from your opponents coming into garage. It's very easy to clear up the defenders, especially if there's no goo mines that are really going to destabilize Young or an Echo drone that's really being active. Now, Goz will find Necrox, pretty good shot here to take down the glass in the back and even more damage. Look at that, so much being done here on the smoke. Still MVK, will find the second. Ghost will go down, no more Legion to worry about. Still, one more gas canister to be used, but there's quite a bit of time actually for this plant, even if it.
Oh no!
Young just goes and gets one and can hit the side.
He's like, what are you playing there? Is that Candy Crush? Let me go ahead and end your game for you. That was unfortunate. That's one of those moments that thankful that Marcio caught that, because that was. I mean, it's an unfortunate one. That's the thing you got to remember about when you're on your.
This generation of kids, dude, right? They're always on their phones. If only they open their eyes and paid attention to the world.
And that is why it's nice to have two of those, because you could potentially have one to watch yourself. But in this case, it was much more important to be watching the defuse plant. But
My sides, Devin.
Yeah, fantastic execution.
I'm sure they're not just hurting because of the gym today, but holy crap.
Jim is not being played yet. They haven't won cash yet.
Get the hell out of here.
Well.
So it makes sense that Rise actually replay the site, because they're like, eh, you know what? I think that was our fault.
Yeah, I mean, to be fair, I don't think they expected the Monty. It was picked into. The way it was played was helping push them out. They also didn't expect the Thermite to be used the way it was.
They got the one kill in that round.
Yeah, no, of course, this is after the rehouse, so the kills are not replaceable. You can replace the round numbers, but you can't replace kills. Maybe a future version of the game will do that, but it definitely is the case now where the scoreboard will have been reset. But yeah, one kill, not great. But either way, a very good round by EG. Gotcha, no slouch.
No, very true. And you know, obviously doing the Thermite is more about, or playing the Thermite is more about doing your job.
It's about
is,
being consistent.
Yes. And this is the question that people ask, you know, when do you know that an anchor is, or not an anchor, but like in this case, when do you know that a support is actually doing their job correctly? When your support is destroying the walls that are required for an assault.
It's generally gadget-based, right? So if the gadgets are going off and they're doing their
thing. If he's droning, is giving information, and if your round is going well, it probably means that your support player is doing more than.
And of course, the beauty about being a hard breacher is you aren't needed early in the round, so you can be droning for your team without the detriment.
What?
He's just going to buck.
Why is the wall soft? You did this against Noble in the last season. What are you doing?
I got to imagine they're using it elsewhere. I mean, very few teams really just go, oh, I don't really need to reinforce. That's more just they need to reinforce something else.
Yeah,
that Canadian, didn't work out.
Yeah, there you go. That's a bit of a...
Put an 8 in 80, and he's going to have to shake that one off.
What?
He's always had a mixed bag.
How did that not blow up?
I don't know. We're going to have the Mythbusters that one at that point. But either way, they're going to wish they had a sledge at this point. And let's see.
So
they'll just go for this garage.
Soft wall, nobody playing in garage. They put the reinforcements downstairs. They're like, you know what? You want garage? Take garage. We'll reinforce the top floor. But in this case, there's not even a mute. There's nothing to deal with it. You're letting go of so much.
It's really all on Hyper. If Hyper can play just a really well-timed flank on the Jaeger, absolutely could be a game changer. But the take is somewhat similar to what was going on before.
I think it's a situation of at what cost. You know, hey, sure. You know, you reinforce in, you give your opponents map control.
It's going to be such a hard retake, though. There's only, like, one way up. I mean, yeah, you could go up the stairs and garage, but good luck getting that far. The Echo is really going to have to hold this off as long as possible until that flank can come out.
This is going to be very complicated here for Ryze. Now, EG are taking their time. There's no C4 downstairs. So, still have to keep that in mind. Canadian... We'll spot the castle barricade right in front by the window, but Necros is just going to watch for rotations. And Young again. He's inside. He'll try to go for the kill. And
again.
He will find Vandal. That's all that he needed. Hey, you can't do anything anymore with the Echo. NVK got the kill on Hyper. 4v2. And it seems like forfeiting control and map control in general is not a good idea. Necros will find one and leaves England on his own. Now, England has done some pretty nutty stuff in the past. We'll be able to go for the retake here. No, Necrox pulls out the pocket sniper rifle, and the PMM will be more than enough to shut down Ryze Nation. I have to question this, as it didn't work in the past. It didn't work here.
And we saw.
And I believe it won't work in the future.
Yeah, we saw the Echo die again while on his phone. This time he got meleeed, but...
Which is kind of worse, right?
Yeah, no, it's definitely... I mean, either way.
At least they got the trade, but at that point, well... The Echo is so focused on the planter.
But that's what he's supposed to be doing. It's his teammates that are supposed to be defending him. But when they're falling so fast and you're just focused on, I just need to stop this plant from happening, you're still, as you're talking about support players doing the job, he is doing his job. It's just the end result is not the most fortunate for him.
Very true.
Beastly, again, trying to sneak in the sixth pick. This time they're going to go to church again. We might not have to see Jim Bedroom at all from Ryze just because, well, they haven't won a round in quite a few rounds, so even if they win this, they'll probably just go back to cash. Or if they really want to get crazy, they could go for that bar defense, I suppose. I mean, that's it's a bit of a long shot and not a recommended thing to do, but...
Okay, alrighty, let's talk about this here. With Habana banned, three rounds and the attack is already pretty darn good.
Yeah.
It's already pretty darn... Usually you're expecting, like, 4 rounds on defense, 2 on the attack, right? You get 3, suddenly you're in a good position. And then you keep in mind, oh, Habana and Maverick are banned.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, that's That's pretty good.
And some of that's credited to the Maestro and Bandit Bands as well, because you stop, first off, them from being able to hold the wall for very long because they're consistently bringing Thatcher. And second off, you're also stopping them from having a very strong gunner on defense, as well as those cameras to be able to help be able to provide intel, as well, you know, for those flankers that we see, they're depending on the echo drones to do that work, or the pulse, for example, and it's, they're not able to make the same kind of accurate calls. They're also not able to do things like try and stop players from moving in with that just giant LMG that Maestro brings. He can bring a lot of denial just from his ability to pre-fire and just suppress the attackers, essentially. So the two things that would really be slowing EG down on the attack have also been taken out. I mean, if they were able to ban Echo as well, I think these rounds would just be shorter, is all.
Yeah. It's not like the Echo has been able to do much.
He's been trying, though, and that's the thing, is they still had to deal with it, and they haven't even necessarily been dealing with it with just bringing, like, a consistent IQ or anything like that. They're just dealing with it by having so much control and often man advantage to be able to just fight it out or just walk up and shoot and or slap him.
Mm-hmm. And we saw both of those instances happening. Though there is Beast League downstairs on the Pulse, and you know, Canadian is a player that played a ton of Pulse and sold us to the stay in clubhouse, especially on Church.
I'm half expecting him to shave his head and put some sunglasses while he plays at some point.
Pay good money to see that. Well, that's the thing. When you play a certain operator in a certain playstyle so much, you kind of know what to expect on the other side of it.
Well, you know what a good player should be doing.
Yes, and in this case, Beastly, at least he's done the work before.
He's played a lot of pulls.
Yeah. So we'll see if he'll be able to put enough pressure on Canadian in the position. Now, here's the thing. Young's going to try to destroy the wall. The Mute Jammer's been taken away. And because the Pulse was so focused on Canadian up above, he wasn't really able to do much about Young. We saw the disruption where he shut down the second set of exothermic charge on the Church wall on the second round, which was where Ryze were able to pick it off. Now, NVK will find one on Vandal. They take down the Mute. And, of course, that's the C4 taken. What was that? Okay, England will just run away and scurry and even get the kill on Necrox out of all things. There's one on the floor, and we'll spot the side, and England not too sure why he was peeking through it. But Gotcha and NVK will get a kill each. Ghost will peek and use that opened reinforced wall by the Church to his advantage. He'll find a second one. Young is down on the floor. 2 versus 2. As the breaching charges are in the hands of NVK, not sure what he can do. Well, he can still find the kill on Ghost. And it's all up to Beastly. No Nitro Cell in hand, but the cardiac sensor should be more than enough to give him information. He sprays into the back through the wall. Can't do much. And the easiest way to plant here is by Black Box. And you see Canadian in the back protecting NVK. You know there's only two angles that you can push through. And that's Canadian to clean up Beastly, putting yet another round on the board for EG. Evil Genius is definitely living up to the name here. Ryze Nation having a bit of success when it comes to, you know, single player plays. You know, a lot of game sense sort of things.
Honestly, England getting away and then getting the kill on Glass almost completely changed the outcome of that
and
round.
Then double.
But then. Ryze Nation lost out on positioning so many times. We saw them die just due to an exposed elbow. It was just the case of just positioning completely working against them. And, you know, EG absolutely capitalizing on that. They see the slightest sliver of you. They're just going to take a ton of shots at it and hope to do enough damage. And a lot of the players were so low on health, they were able to deal with it. But the prone crawl from England was definitely a mistake. I mean, they were able to get away with the sneak defuse once on that hatch. Trying to go for a prone crawl, you're going to throw your elbows way out. I know that's not something you're going to think about again. Angles are something that you can't see what the opponent's going to see at the same time, so you don't know that you're going to necessarily be exposed. But being prone is one good way to make sure that from someone attacking from above that you're going to expose the most amount of your body possible. It's one of the worst things you can be doing against someone on a hatch like that. So it was definitely not the play.
No, but that's not it, Chief.
Yeah, no. But also the positioning you were mentioning of Beastly. You see, more often than not, a Pulse is going to be a lot safer playing inside Church, but he's also going to be able to call out to that Mute when to have that second jammer ready. So it wasn't a case of, like, let me try and trick this real quick. He maybe could even put a Mute jammer down on the side if he needed to and try and jam it from a different position just in case they weren't placing the thermite charge in the right spot, but he was also going for the middle to try and hopefully escape wherever it was, if there was one placed down. It's tricky, and just the lack of the bandit's really problematic for the defense.
Now, the thing is here, impact tricks are definitely powerful. The easiest way to deal with the impact tricks is to just crouch. You just crouch, and then you can't really do anything against it in that situation. So the thermite will just have a clear way in. Now, Hyper, you just sit upstairs, and they know that Ryze are breaking their vigil here because they did spot him through the round. Of course, in the preparation phase, you just see those lines on the side. You're like, okay, they're probably going to roam. And I'm not sure. I don't think he was bringing any bulletproof cameras, which is also something to keep in mind for later. No, only impact grenades. So Hyper is going to be mostly focused on aggressive plays, but he's got to be very careful because EG are tightening the noose.
The timing.
Oh,
wow,
he
it
finds
worked.
It. Perfect. Canadian will get shot down. He even has a mute jammer on the stairs, also to protect him, which is pretty darn sweet. It's going to make things a bit more difficult here for EG, but you also see Ghost in support. You rarely want to roam solo upstairs.
Like I said before, though, it's a suicide mission either way.
Yeah, might as well, you know, put in someone extra to help you out. And in this case, Hyper will go down, and Ghost still alive for not for too long. NVK will clean him up.
A two-for-two trade, though, is worth it in this case.
Yeah, Vigil and the Legion, but they take down, you know, losing the Legion is kind of equivalent to losing the Capitao. The Vigil exchangeable for pretty much any op on the attack, but you know, they were kind of hoping for maybe taking out younger Necrox, but here losing Canadian before he's able to use his grenades, pretty darn good
deal.
Not
to mention they're only soft breacher.
And look at the amount of time.
Absolutely. So I would say that trade was worth it. It wasn't ideal. Like you said, there are better operators they could have taken out potentially, but they also took out two very useful ones still. They were definitely not operators that you want to be playing this without. And they're going to really have to rely on this smoke push. Necrox is going to absolutely have to hit his shots here. But at the same time, they could mess this up. They're going to have to be playing very smart on the pulse again to catch this, because he's just going right in. But there's a C4 coming out from that pulse.
Oh, he spots one in the back, and Beastly instantly taken out. But Vandal hits the second C4 from behind the armory. You see him by the green box. Vandal waiting for the peek as MVK has some time here to maneuver. Will he be able to find the mute? Yes, he will. Vandal going down 1v1. It's now NVK versus England. NVK! He clutches it! Finds the headshot on England right after taking out the mute. Beautiful play. Everybody's been saying, where's MVK? Where has he been? He's been hibernating just for this.
He's been playing a lot of Thatcher, and he definitely can have rounds like that where he's absolutely pulling it out. And in that case, absolutely clutch. In that situation, he knew exactly how it was going to be played against. He got the one kill and still had to go for the plant. They had some idea that the pressure was going to be on to do that. The approach that was most likely was going to come from the church. So because of that, yes, he did get a little bit lucky on the timing, but he figured, I'm going to start to bait this out. In doing so, they're going to peek me to see if I'm planting or not. If they don't see me, they're going to assume that I'm planting, in which case I'm going to peek on them, surprise them, with a potential pre-fire in the one spot I'm hoping they will be at. And it was a little bit of a gamble in a way, but he still had some time to play with before he was forced into a plant. And because of that was the perfect time to be doing that. So that was absolutely the right play from NBK. And unfortunately, just not having any intel left on the defense to be able to decide when to peek that absolutely backfired. So well played by NBK. And that was a bit of a desperate round for EG. Luckily, at least they had enough time left. Partially because Necrox pushed in so quickly once they got dirt open. Once they decided this is the way it has to
they
happen.
They needed to move.
Yeah, that's the IGL call. I got to imagine, you know, Troy's calling that. He's like, okay, we need to push dirt.
Go, go, go,
we need
go.
To push dirt. Go. Yeah, absolutely. Smoke, get in there, get your kills. C4 started going off, did quite a bit of damage, and almost completely stopped that.
Now, here's the thing. I love this play from EG. Having the mirror window when there's no Havana is a huge deal. You can afford not bringing a mute because you can still fight. Play on the outside, and I think a better way of doing it is having a soft wall on one end. I think I'm going to highlight something that NIP does, for example, which is reinforcing left and middle, or right and middle, and then leaving the left soft so they can fight it.
Yeah.
And also sometimes having a mirror as well. Through.
Well, you want to fight Moto, because Moto kind of sometimes becomes a linchpin of a lot of attacks that rely on setting up for that plant, either whether it be to go through church or even just through the Moto door.
All right. Hyper's going to try to shoot down. Not going to find anyone. In the meantime, Canadian is roaming on the Vigil, an operator that he's been fairly successful on. in the past.
Seems to be his go-to a lot of times when he's not playing Pulse, but we'll see.
MVK watching in from the blue side here, and shoots a couple of shots in the back. Can't find the hit on the Ashe. No problem. Just falls back, and he knows, okay, I got ADSs. I'm very protected in here, and Ryze are bringing utility to clear out the ADSs, but NVK has the potential to rotate away. Hyper is just looking here to fight against the Canadian, who is very aggressively pushed up, and he's actually going to walk back through the main hallway and not to the side of Moto, which is what Ryze were expecting. Now, they'll spot the mirror window. In the meantime, see the Buck destroying as much of the forward as possible. Now, there's a potential angle that you can find on a player's downstairs. It's a bit of a tricky one, but like, you need to destroy the side, from the hallway into the bar, and it's a very tiny angle that you get access to, but it's not really something that you can really rely on. It's very complicated even to show on here. It's basically, if I had a pen to draw on the monitor, maybe that should help out.
I think you almost tried.
I did actually have my pen to try.
It's good thing it was the other way around.
But that's the big deal here. EG, they leave the wall soft on the hallway.
Yeah.
And that's something that Ryze are definitely going to try to use to their advantage. Now, EG can use that to their side because...
They can also use it as bait.
Exactly. And so...
Ooh, that nice little crack there.
They're going to try to use that to their advantage as Vanel will rotate in and try to maneuver around from the tunnel site. It makes a lot of sense, but might be too late. 27 seconds on the clock. And EG are just ready for any assault that Ryze like to go for. Young, in the meantime, also has Goo Mines in play. And Hyper, whoa, finds the angle. Canadian, this Ghost will find one more. Necrox, 12 seconds left on the clock. Young will get one, but Hyper will refrag. Gotcha going down. NVK to turn into 2v3. Fuser not set yet, as Ghost will get NVK, and he'll get one more. Young to go down. The IQ rush from Ghost. Man, that was...
Yeah, what a series of plays from him. Absolutely a great round for him.
That was the definition of calculated aggression.
Well, that's the thing is, they took advantage of the fact that EG were mostly starting to get set in static positions.
Mm-hmm.
Because of that, they were able to land their shots. They took advantage of the, okay, EG just holding, and they're just stalling out as long as they can. That is the right play to be playing from EG.
Mm-hmm.
But then Ryze Nation are like, okay, well, we know where they're at. We're, you know, taking advantage of droning, getting some time to actually get set up in position. And then it was just hitting their shots is what it came down to. The fact that Ghost especially was landing those shots was what won them that round, because had they missed, you know, even one or two of those shots, there's definitely a good chance that round would have gone to EG, because we would have seen them start to kind of swing back, get some man vantage, and then just time wouldn't have been on their side, because when you're planting, you can't be fighting.
Yep.
Defenders don't have that. They don't have to do anything where it takes a person out of a gunfight.
Now we go up to Cash. EG will play that and see 10 kills for NVK.
And that's, of course, since their last three hosts.
Yeah, which is after the second round. So round three until round 18, under five rounds.
Yeah.
So NVK really putting up the numbers here, and it's refreshing to see that again. But EG will nowadays he's moved away from a fragging role that mostly is up to Canadian, and we see a lot of plays from Geo in that perspective.
Geo's been playing very aggressive.
That's basically the role that he has on the squad. No longer the case with a lot of people that are used to NVK in year one and year two until the end of it. But I like the adaptation from Ryze. They bring the Jackal. They're like, okay, we're worried about any...
They're worried about Canadian being on that vigil again.
Exactly. Well, in this case, none of that there. So is it a bit of a waste of a pick? We'll have to see.
I mean, it's interesting playing the Echo there. You still get the ACOG, which is nice, but you risk your potential death. However, you also have your own Yokai drones to be able to watch over the railing for you, potentially safely.
Well, you say that.
Potentially is the important word there.
You know, somebody highlighted this as... Well, he had his AirPods on. Apparently, this is a North American thing. I really don't understand it. You even probably don't. It's a youngin' thing, where it's like, I can't hear you over the sound of me being rich because I have AirPods on. And just I really don't get that sort of thing. Laxing. So, that aside, England will start to play through the exothermic charge, and he'll destroy the wall. As you've seen, EG are not bringing the bandit because they can't.
But interestingly enough, no Thatcher coming out from Ryze.
Yes, and I think they got I don't want to say lucky, but they got lucky. The fact that there was no mute, it would have made things a bit more complicated for Ryze to really...
The nice thing is you can detect that. You can just drone near it. If you get no static, you know it's clear. Because you know there's no bandit. And you don't have to worry about... Yeah, I mean, you'd see the electricity either way, but it's like you can detect that there's no one doing anything about it.
All right. Well, Ghost maneuvering in as, in this case, EG are not doing what Ryze were performing before. They're actually going to stick at least a player down here. Now, there's NVK as well to support his teammates, just maneuvering around the map. They're going to try to impact your kid, but that was perfect bait. You can chuck that impact from a while away or a distance away, but still, losing Gacha here is not the greatest positions. However, he should have been able to deploy the majority of his goo mines. In the meantime, there's NVK that's also trying to fight within the lounge, and will he be able to find the kill? Yes, he will. Hyper shot down. And Vandal, though, will find Canadians. A quick refrag and an important operator remove both now the Legion and the Echo. Out of play for EG.
I like how NVK took his kill and then immediately ran to reposition so they could not refrag on it.
Now he's in oil pit. He'll move around to the blue stairs. And Ghost and the squad do have control of the servers if they would like to go in and plant. Now Beastly will spot NVK. And that is huge here for the Jackal, which means that Ryze can comfortably play in a potential 4v2 without needing to worry about players in the back, but Vandal steps into a goo mine and it gets finished off by Necrox as one last gas canister will get used. He'll pull out the shotgun, but Ghost is too fast for him. Sprayed through the wall. Ghost moving in from the side. NVK will find the kill on Beastly. NVK for the second. Ghost to go down. C4 will not connect, but it's England on his own. He'll find one kill, not the second. NVK disrupting Ryze long enough for Young to get the last shot in with the Vector. And it's a great thing that they did not line up for the Thermite. EG put another round on the board. And this gets very complicated for Ryze, who now face a loss. Yet another one. And it seems like Clubhouse is not their match.
Nope, definitely does. It seems like that's the case. Ghost, though, seemingly finding his stride a bit more on attack than he did on defense. That was another good round for him. Just playing very fast and aggressive, working out in terms of at least catching one. You know, he was able to catch Necrox there, who just did not have enough time to switch weapons. So capitalizing on that definitely helped shape things a little bit. But it was just too many people left for England to find in time, and they stacked up on him. Canadian going to tease that he's going to be playing on the Vigil, but there goes the doc instead. So we'll see if he's going to be bringing your bulletproof camera you mentioned before.
I always have to alternate between certain operators that I talk about.
I mean, either one of those could have brought the bulletproof camera.
Ah, there you go.
But he is going to be bringing it on this loadout.
Makes a lot of sense. I wonder where he's going to place that because, well, actually, it makes a lot of sense to place it in the back of the armory where he can look down the hallway.
Yeah.
Which is a big counter to what Ghost was doing before, because all that Ghost did is just maneuver around, and Ryze are not consistently bringing in Ashe, so you know it kind of gives you a bit more flexibility here. And where is he going to set it? Possibly right behind him here. That's a good spot.
Yeah, he's always meleeing those things on that shelf. He's been doing that for a long time now as well. It's just
there you
habitual
go,
thing.
That's the spot I was talking about. He can vault up or he can just put it on here. And there you go. This is usually where you would put an Evil Eye. And the really easiest way to deal with this is an Ashe. But again, Ryze are not really bringing the operator. So you can deal with that pretty easily.
I mean, yeah. It's definitely going to be potentially problematic for them, but they do have the Twitch drones.
Very true. They can shock it from the side.
Yeah, it's. I mean, it's. You have to be a little more precise in a way than you might have to be with a remote breach, but still doable.
It's a good thing that we're no longer in the days where, if you chucked out your second drone, your first one got destroyed. I'm glad that does not.
Those quality of life changes we tend to take for granted now that we forget. The drone economy was definitely different when you just replaced your drone.
Yeah, it was a recession.
Absolutely. Well, either way, they are starting to at least make some progress here for this potential attack. I mean, in a way, it's good for EG in a sense that they didn't win this bomb site before, that they won cash, so they can go back here. But obviously, had they won that, then they'd already be done.
Yeah.
So, either way, they're not forced onto a bad bomb site.
And it's interesting how Canadian is able to just move up and not be punished. And it seems like he's very confident and comfortable in the position he puts himself
in. He's got
in.
Pretty good game sense, and I think he's relying on that pretty heavily.
Very true. And it does allow him to relay information back to his teammates, and of course, realizing, oh, even the mirror window's been pre-opened. So they're going to start to fight.
Just hatches. That's all they're going to open. No church wall open, no dirt wall open, all just right. hatches.
Fair enough.
So that's got to be like a Moto kind of take along with blue, potentially.
It's okay because the Mira, say it with me now, it's a hold that works
two or three ways.
Both ways. So as one great poet has said in the past, Devin.
It does mean poet.
Devin Emzoas.
That's literally what it means.
Actually?
Yeah, that's what Devin means.
Really?
Oh, wow. Nice job, Hyper. That's MVK down. This is a lot more doable, and Ghost is still playing his aggressive IQ.
Now, taking down MVK, who's been instrumental here for EG in the frag game, something we haven't heard of in quite a while. Gotcha actually puts himself very close up in the hallway and has the soft wall here to fight against his opponents. He'll fire in the back, but not enough to really do any damage. Kumain will get thrown into the side of the wall. Canadian finds one as he'll try to heal himself back up using the mirror window in the back of blue to support himself and at least gain some information. Or actually, it's been pre-destroyed. EG are really trying to use everything in the aggression.
Well, they know they have to take blue to make this work for the most part because they just did hatches, unless they just want to straight up drop into armory, and that's where Gotcha is.
Yeah, he's the perfect operator to deal with this. Beastly will go down. Young will find, well, actually, with the help of Canadian, find the kill on Ghost, and Young whips up the pistol and takes down England. That's all she wrote. EG will take round number 9 and the entire game. 7-2 victory for EG and Ryze. I questioned it at the beginning and I will reiterate. Why Clubhouse?
I mean, if EG had played Clubhouse before and shown some things that were that they thought maybe they could deal with, I could have seen that being a little bit more of a logical choice. But either way, you know, it just means, I guess, the upside is they don't have to play it again next week because it's auto-banned.